He preached a little tiny sermon for me, explained to me that anything I had done up until this point, I was 23 years of age then, he said, would all be washed away, forgotten forever, that God would never hold against me anything I had done up until this point. But anything I did after this, God would reckon with me about it. So I was very happy about all this. And I'm standing here and I'm absorbing all this. And he takes me to a baptistry. Nothing like this, of course, just the horse tank in the corner of the basement. We watered cattle out of it on the farm where I grew up. Not all that illustrious, I would say. But it doesn't have to be. The only two ingredients that are necessary is water and the name of Jesus. It can be in a pool. It can be in a baptistry. It can be in a river, a stream. And so they took me into this little corner and had me climb over the edge of this horse tank. I stepped in the water. It wasn't very deep, so I had to sit down. And he explained to me that, you know, you hold your nose here and hold your wrist here. Ever been through that? How many been through that? And he says, I'm going to lay you back very easily in the water. Put you all the way down under. In Jesus' name, then I'll bring you back up. And just lift your hands and begin to praise the Lord when you come out of the water. So, but here's the unusual thing. Before I came into this, I would never look into the eyes of a Pentecostal, because there was a light in your eyes. Your eyes shined. And from the outside, looking at you, I could see a light in you. Now, I'd look at your lapel. I'd look at your chin. But I'd never look in your eyes, because I couldn't fight the tears back when I saw that light. There was something about it. It was so real to me. It was so real to me. The two fellows that picked me up this morning at the hotel to bring me here, I turned and looked at, I looked right into your eyes. His eyes were shining. I thought, it reminded me of when I first looked into Pentecostal eyes. They just shine with a light. There's just a light. I wouldn't look into your eyes. I'll never forget when I felt my body going back under that water. The last thing I heard him say was, I baptize you by immersion in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, the remission of your sins, and you shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. And I was under. I went all the way down, but I could feel my body begin to come up as he lifted me. And from the point of breakage on the surface of that water, I could literally, I'm not exaggerating, I'm not trying to be dramatic, I'm telling you how it was for me. From the point of breakage on the surface of that water, I could feel, as that water slipped down off my body and I came out of it, I could feel 23 years of sin slip from my body. I could feel it slip from my body. And they were worshiping and rejoicing. I was worshiping, but I was interested in doing something they didn't know anything about. I finally climbed over the edge of that baptistry and I ran to the dressing room, to the mirror. I wanted to see if I could see in my face, in my eyes, that light. I took my wet hands and began to run over the mirror, and it was there. It was there. I could see the light. I could see that light. It was there. And I stood there and began to cry. This thing was coming to me. But I feel so badly today. I've always felt badly. I would to God I could redo that baptismal service. I would send out written invitations. I'd invite the whole world. Thank you.